Okay, any questions, clarifications? Recording? Any questions, clarification from last time? The five skandhas, the Buddhist theory of creation. Okay? Very often, a theory of creation becomes necessary in all philosophies, because, including science, because there's a world here, you have to explain it away. You have to start with what you see and experience. You can have any postulate. Okay? Then we have a pramana. Okay. Even those who say, like here, there is nothing, but I am experiencing something, how are you going to explain it? Because starting point is this: I see you see me, we see a world. Okay. Then, what is the reality behind the world? It is there, it is not there, God, this, that, whatever. But you cannot get away by saying world is not there, unless you explain how it has come. Okay. So that is why the Buddhist theory is a skandhas. Okay. And he said, I mean, these five groups, skandhas is a group, these five groups make up the world. If you question further, where has the five groups come from, like we saw last time? From Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Apa, Prithvi. They make the whole creation. It is there in, this five element mode is there in all oriental philosophies. Okay, all of them it is there. We are using the word element for want of any other word. Not really an element, like air is not one element. But for want of another. Always allowed to say tanmatras. And then you understand it as tanmatras. Okay. Yeah. Or panchabhutas. Understand it as panchabhutas. Yeah. Like there's a recent report in the Indian newspaper that the Ayurvedic setup in BHU is teaching Bhuta Vidya to the students. In Ayurveda, Bhuta Vidya, and especially applicable to psychological cases where people are hearing sounds, this, that, etc., those type of, which is fine, it's a psychological disorder, and if Ayurveda has a paradigm of treatment, look into it. BBC picked it up and said Bhuta Vidya, so they must ask something, what does Bhuta mean? Ghosts. So Indian universities are talking about ghosts. Newspaper report. Yeah, yeah, paranormal activity, paranormal studies. Yeah, this is what we call biased media reporting, you know. Yeah, biased. BBC is supposed to be a very objective, very this thing, but look at the way they are reporting. It shows a clear bias against the third world, you know, so-called third world. Yeah. It's a clear bias. Why will you report something like that? Check up, no? Journalists are supposed to find facts, check up facts before they report something. Especially prestigious setups. Anyway. So, panchabhutas. So, take it as panchabhutas, not as ghosts. Yeah. As building blocks for the whole thing. And the last verse, the 12th verse, you see, saw that Atma is said to be Hanu Upadana Varjitam. You can't. An object here, this recorder, I can pick it up. I need not pick it up. I can give it up. Okay? Upadana to pick it up, Hana to give. Atma is not available for that. Then he says, look at another Mahabhuta, Akasha. Akasha also you can't pick up, you can't drop, no? Like how I can pick up the recorder or drop it? Can you pick up Akasha or drop it? Can you take your space with you everywhere? You can't. Now, Swamiji, what about my personal space? There's no personal space. Personal space is a concept beyond which you don't like somebody coming in. Physically close to you, beyond a point. under the person as a friend or a family member or whatever, or someone you care about, that's different. But otherwise, that's, or traveling by Virar locals. Okay. Bombay trains Virar locals. What do you mean personal space? If there is personal space, there's two people will come in there. That's how it is. Okay. Yeah. Because people can be funny in the idea of, personal space is only an idea. And people can be funny in it. Like the other day, I met some lady from Bandra. She's a Westerner from a European country living here. He says, you know, I said, so there was a program in our house and I had gone for that. I said, fine. Beautiful house, nice 3-bedroom apartment. Only husband and wife staying there. Okay. Maybe this size or maybe a little smaller. Only husband and wife, 3-bedroom. And sophisticated building. So when I went up by the lift, I didn't see anybody else. I came down, I didn't see anybody else. Though the building has about, I think it's a big building, about maybe 14, 15 flats. This is the background. And she tells me, you know, in India, I find it very difficult to deal with the crowds. I said, I can understand that if you go to the market, you go to Linking Road, or the marketplace. No, 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 even staying in my house. Staying in your house? 3 bedrooms, only a 1 couple. But the building, there are so many people. Yeah, but do you, how often do you come in touch with them? Rarely. So then what is the issue? Here. There are so many people, no, in the building. There are so many people, but you're not interacting with them. You're not even seeing them. Okay, that's a side light. But space, you can't carry with you. Space you can't pick up. You can't say, I don't want the space. You can say, I don't want a flat and leave it around. I don't want an apartment and leave it. You can't say, I don't want space. But if Hano Padana Varjitam is space, your Atma is also like that. Hai nahi hai. Is space an object? Like your table, chair, etc. No. So Atma also is not there. Like space. It's all only emptiness. It's only the great void. Shunyaha. This is the last verse we saw. Okay. Any questions on this, or this is clear? Okay. Surprisingly, it is not only the Buddhists that says everything was created from nothing. Even the Bible says it. But Bible puts a God there and says God created everything out of nothing. If you read the Bible, it is there. God created the world out of nothing. So the idea of a material cause is a little bit shaky there. Shaky there. Unless by nothing you mean nothing other than himself. Nothing else. Nothing outside. Then it makes sense. Okay. Then going further, he says, now from 13th verse onwards, we are negating some of the aspects of Buddhist philosophy. Okay. Ittyevam bhauda siddhanti bhashamano nishiddhaye shunyam che jagatau hetuhu jagadevana siddhyati. Simple argument first. He says, ityevam bhauda siddhanti bhashamanaha. When the bhauda siddhanti is talking like this, if you notice Shankara and all the other writers, they never call it Buddha's philosophy. They call it bhauda. Bauddha's philosophy. Bauddha are the followers of Buddha. Because Buddha is a recognized wise person, no issues. There are so many wise people in India. Every generation has dozens of them. In Buddha's generation, and dozens. Many were there. He stood out. He stood out. That's purely prarabdha. There are so many wise people. Unknowns. Some known. some very well known. That will all be different. Okay? So here, the followers of Bodha, okay, Bodha Siddhanti, Bhashabanaha, when he's saying like this, Nishiddhayate, we are negating that. What is the first argument? Shunya meva jagato hetuhu. If shunya, nothingness, is the cause of the jagat, the world, then jagadeva na siddhyati, the world itself will not be there. If the cloth is the cause for the kurta is seen as nothing but cloth. No? Correct? The kurta is seen as nothing but cloth. The color of the kurta is the color of the cloth. The feel of the kurta is the feel of the cloth. The fall of the kurta is the fall of the cloth. When you all go, you see, now, where does it fall as well, etc., etc. Correct? Jagat came from shunyam. So what should you see? Shunya, nothingness. Like here you are seeing cloth. If this is made of nothingness, what will you see? Nothingness, like the emperor's clothes. Like the story of the emperor's clothes. From nothingness you made the cloth. So what do you see? Nothing. In other words, you will not experience the world. Because what we should be, when I'm wearing the kurta, what am I experiencing? The cloth, no? Feels nice here. Cloth, because the feel is nice. Especially when it gets a bit old. Old clothes are always have a comfort about it. Yeah, it feels nice. So, from nothingness it was made, then what should you experience? Nothingness. And if you are also not there to experiencing it, nothingness. Okay, nothingness alone. Big argument, which is contradicted by your experience because you are experiencing something. No? You are experiencing something. So you can't say it is nothingness. What it is you can debate upon. But it cannot be nothingness. Because something is there. You are experiencing it as something. Therefore something has to be there. That's he clarifying in the next verse. He says, Gata shunyam pata shunyaha. Iti kaihi pratipadyate. Naiva bhasate shunyam chen. Jagad naravishanavan. Gata shunyam pata shunyam iti kaihi pratipadyate. You should experience what? Gataha as shunyaha. Gataha, pot, vessel. Shunyaha. Is it shunyaha? I'm drinking the water. Water also should be shunyaha. But that's not true. Gata shunyam pata shunyam is cloth. Therefore, gata shunyaha, pata shunyaha, iti kaihi pratipadyate. Does anybody experience it like that? Does anybody say it doesn't exist? Then how can you say shunyam is a cause for it? Because the properties of the cause will be reflected in the effect. May not be all the properties, but some of it has to be reflected in the effect. Whatever is modified, then the modification will be reflected. That's one fundamental thing that cannot change. Then he says, Naiva bhasate shunyam chet. And since shunyam is not manifest as awarefulness, is known, then jagat will become nara vishanavat. The world will become like a man's horns. A man's horn is not there, world will also not be there. Do you experience a man's horns? Two horns on his head, you know. I accept some people behave like that, but that apart. They behave as they horns, butting people all the time. But you don't experience man's horn. Similarly, you will not experience the world. It will not be an object of your experience. If shunya is the basis, it will not be an object of your experience. Okay. Is this argument clear? Okay. Then he says, Vastu arthi kim upadya upapadayan. Okay. Bharat kim parityajen. Kim kim vidhyat nishidhyedva. Shunyatva svasya atmanaha. Svasya chatmanaha. Vastu arthi kim upadayad. Okay. I'm feeling hungry. If you're feeling hungry, go eat some food. Correct? But that is shunya. If that is shunya and experience is shunya, how will you take on something to satisfy yourself? And I'm carrying a big load. My bag is getting heavier. A big load. Okay. Kim parityajet. But that is shunya. Do you have to keep it aside? Your bag is heavy. I think nowadays the fashion of carrying big bags is coming back. No? I read it somewhere. You know? Fashionable to carry big bags. Yeah, there was a time when people would carry big bags. Then it all became small clutches, etc. Then I read somewhere back, big bag. So, oh, it's heavy, yaar. I have to keep it down. It's shunya. Where will it be heavy? Therefore, bharartha. Someone carrying a load will not feel the need for relieving himself, na? Keep it aside. Take a break. Why? Shunya. Okay. Koi vidhi nishedhadva. Then is there something like do this, don't do that? This is specially applicable to Buddhism because there's 365 rules. They're very strict in what you follow, what you don't follow, etc. Therefore, vidhi, what you're supposed to do. Nisheda, what you're not supposed to do. Kuch hai? Everything is shunyam. What are your rules for? For something that doesn't exist. For dressing up your hair, you can have 50 different rules. How it should be cut, how it should be this, your what? Kelp treatment, your protein treatment, your creatine treatment, all that you can have. Okay? How you will color it, how you will fashion it, how will you... Why? Because it's there. So now I'm going to make 25 rules for my horns. How it should be taken care of, how it should be polished, how the point should be maintained. Kuch hai? Hai nahi hai. Vidhi nishedha kimartham jat. Shunya swasya cha atmana. Because your atma itself is shunya. Therefore, for whom is this vidhi nishedha? For an outside object you can't have. For yourself you can't have. Atma shunya. If I am shunya, then what rules and regulations am I supposed to follow? Hum hai nahi hai na. You can't say, main hu na. Main nahi hu na, you'll have to say. And you can't say me nahi hu na unless you are there to say it. Therefore, the shunyavada contradicts all experience. Hey, but your Advaita also contradicts all experience. That we will see. That we will see how it is, you know. Okay. Avisidhe nirakritam, tene nirakutam, tasmat sarvamidam jagat, skandanam paramanunam, na sanghateti astityet. Okay. Avisidhe nirakritam, it should be kartum, no? Nirakutam. Tasmat sarvam idam jagat. What is the word there?
Nirakutam.
Nirakutam.
Kutam.
Nirakutam.
Hey.
Akutam. Huh? Akritam it should be, yeah. No. Nirakritam. Tasmat sarvam idam jagat. If the world doesn't have a basis in anything, in Shunya, where will the world be? What is sustaining the world? Your Kshanikamada, momentary existence, etc., you can talk about only if there is some existence behind. Otherwise, even momentariness will not be there. There will be no world. Or, the moment you understand it as Shunya, what should happen? I'm Shunya, you cease to exist. World should cease to exist. Everything should happen. Okay. In short, there will be no experience of the world. Okay. Then he says, very important argument here. Okay. Skandhanam paramanunam cha sanghatayati asti chet. Okay. Now he says, now coming to your theory that sanghatas, the five groups make up the world. Okay, the five groups make up the world and the person, because Vedana Sangha etc. is there. Okay. Sanghato na vinahetum jada ghatapata adayaha. He says, you don't see a ghata, pata, etc., a pot, a cloth, coming together on its own. Na vina hetuhu. There always has to be an efficient principle there, an intelligent principle there, making the thing come together. It's a powerful argument for the establishment of God, okay? For supporting the idea of God, of Ishvara. Not as God sitting somewhere and creating, but as the intelligence behind the whole thing. Because if there is no intelligence, who is going to put these paramanus together to form something? Even the random selection and the chaos, order emerging from chaos and science is being questioned now. Because they tried this experiment. If everything has come randomly, let us take the alphabets of the English language, easier to work on, only 26 alphabets. Okay. I am friendly with all the 25 alphabets of the English language. I don't know why. You got it? Yeah. I don't know why. Because you leave out why is only 25. English language is 26 alphabets, simple language. Now random choice. So this is a computer stimulated experiment. I don't know where exactly, but okay. Juggle the whole thing. Like how you played these world building games. You put in a juggle and pick up a handful and then you arrange it to form a word. Like that they tried to arrange. And let us see how long it will take to create a library of books. Because I creating the world, no? Knowledge. Knowledge only in the English language. What about knowledge in other subjects? That forget, only English. They found that the time taken, projection of course, mathematical projection, would be longer than the life of the world. Are you getting the idea? Random selection, one word you got. Sky, earth. But that's not a sentence yet. You have to form a sentence, no? Imagine Shakespearean work, one sentence forming. Random say. That's okay, you can have various words and then arrange together this, that, etc. With a computer simulation, they found the time taken would be longer than the life of the whole universe. So to create a library of limited knowledge of the world is going to take that time. What about the world itself? Random. And even that randomness is being operated by whom? By the guy sitting on the computer, no? Correct? Anything which is intelligently put together presumes an intelligence behind it. The world is intelligently put together. So that's all evolution. Yeah, but there has to be something to, there has to be, for evolution there has to be a few things. One, there has to be matter. Second, there has to be infrastructure. Third, there has to be certain definitive laws. Fourth, there has to be possibilities. Okay. Fifth, there has to be some order at work, principles of what you call principles of nature. All these has to be there. They cannot come by randomness. Randomness is stopping at one point. There has to be a huge intelligence behind the whole thing. I was randomness, how much can you get? Yeah. Whether you take the body, this body, or that body of a tree. It's all intelligently put together. There's a lot of intelligence behind the whole thing. The very fact that we can study it and discover all these laws shows that there was intelligence behind it. In fact, the world is nothing but intelligence. Solidified. Yeah. Therefore, by itself you don't find it coming together. You need to have an intelligence behind the whole thing. Then he says, now he is being a bit dismissive. Okay. Mahanubhava bhuyasam iti bhrantascha manyate Atma palaka pang bhaudaha kimarti charati vratam. Mahanubhava bhuyasam. I will become a wise person. Like my role model Buddha, I will become a wise person. Iti bhranta manyate. If you are thinking of shunya, then bhranta manyate tu hai nahi hai yaar. You are not there. What mahanubhava you are going to become? What realized soul you are going to become? What are you going to realize? I am not there. Nahi ho sakta. Okay. Atma palapako bhaudaha. Atma apalapako bhaudaha. The Buddhist who is saying, I am not there, kimarti charati vratam. Why are you following all these disciplines? Subhi utne ka barabar, ya meditation karne ka ansing. Then between this two, time to this time, this organ is functioning, supported, this time to this time. The Buddha very thing about it. Yeah. Get up at 3 o'clock and meditate. Why? That's the best time for it. Yeah. After that, breathing exercise, etc. Because the lung channel is functioning. Yeah. After that, stomach channel takes over. So breakfast, etc. Then this, etc. After lunch, you'll feel asleep. But the best time to catch a nap is between 3 and 5. So wait until 3 o'clock. Then meditate in the night before going to sleep. I mean, your whole day is geared by discipline. Kiske liye? Why are you doing all that? To recognize your shunya, final. What is the final goal of all this? I'm not there. I'm not there, you directly there. Na? Mat karo na kuch bhi. It is like saying, that's a snake on the rope, okay? It's a snake. Achha, it's a snake on the rope. Main usko aarti utarta hun. Does anybody do that for the snake that you see on the rope? When you know it is a, or you have been told, it is a rope, not a snake. Hey, abhi naga panchami hai na, thoda usko doodh pilayega. Rope snake ko. But you also have the same thing. We have all these rules and regulations until you know the truth. Once you know the truth, ko vidhi ko nishedaha. No rule, no regulation. There even after that, after your realization, you have to follow some of those things. Why you have to keep it going, na? The energy, etc. You have to keep it going. Why do you have to keep it going? Kiske liye? Nikal jayenge, nikal jayenge, na? Because hai to nahi hai. Are you getting it? It's not there. So you don't have to do anything then. Therefore, why are you following all these disciplines? If you are saying Atma is not there, Atma Shunyaha, we are not saying that. Therefore, we are not into that. We are saying you have to prepare our mind to know all these. To know what is your true nature. But that is valid only if there is something to be known. If what is to be known is nothingness, then the whole thing is not valid. If the whole thing will be valid only if there is a purpose in it. Purpose cannot be nothingness. Purpose cannot be nothingness. Because if nothingness is the basis, then you don't have to do anything. And when the skandhas drop anyway, you are resolved back into nothingness. No? What's your problem? Yeah. So, this is a lot happening. Okay.
So there is no thinking at all, it's only belief only.
It is a belief only. It was a case of speculating about the Atma without a pramana. Because Buddha didn't teach. There are so many wise people in India who don't teach, who are not teachers. I met so many of them. Great souls, great wise. Can go and have a chat with them, great souls. You know, it's so easy to recognize them as great souls. They know the truth of that. But they're not teachers. They don't care to teach. Or you go and ask them something, they'll give you some simple things. For whatever reason. I don't want to go into the reason for that. Either they don't know how to teach, or they think the people are not ready. Therefore, give them simple things. Like Buddha gave everyone the Eightfold Path. So live your life healthy first here, then we will see about the Atma, etc. Get your attitude right, get your this thing right. Atma ka baad baad mein dekhega. See, that way I respect all the wise people. Yeah. Christ was talking to whom? Shepherds, fisher folk, etc. You put me in front of them, my Mauni Baba ban jayega. What will I say? I have nothing to say. I wouldn't have the language to communicate. He had. So he communicated what he could, what they would understand. So every wise person did that. I'm lucky at least some intelligent people are sitting here, educated people, I can communicate. Yeah. I can communicate. So for whatever reason, Buddha didn't talk. Because of that, the followers left the Shastra out. Plus he criticized some of our extra relying on rituals, etc. Even now you'll find, na? South India, mein. Hey, Sunday evening. All of us friends are meeting. What time? 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock is still Rahu Kalam. I'll come 5 minutes after that. You're not doing a big project. You're just friends are meeting. Because Sunday 4:30 to 6 is Rahu Kalam. 5:30 we are meeting, 6 o'clock, after 6. Where Rahu Kalam you are not supposed to do, sir, in the good things. Are you getting there? All these type of things come up. We are pushing it too far. Pushing it too. So Buddha said, hey, take it easy. He negated some of these things. Yeah. So because he negated that, people junked the whole pramana of the Veda out. Then you are speculating. So when you are speculating without a pramana, there is no data available for your speculation. Except what you see in experience. There is no other data available. Because of that, they came to these wrong conclusions. They accepted the Maya part of it, on top of it. Because if they are not accepted the Maya part of it, they will not be different from the Charvakas. They accepted rebirth. And they accepted karma. All these things they accepted. They accepted all the meditations. They accepted the energy work, the tantric part. All that they accepted. Yeah. Because I have been going into Tibetan Buddhism, Taoism in China and all. I've been examining all these things. They have accepted all these. The Ambedkarite Buddhists will be surprised to know that in traditional Buddhism they chant Om. Yeah, in the mantra itself it is there. Yeah. And many of the meditations, Om is chanted. Where did they get Om from? Vedic tradition in this land, all this was there. Therefore they got it. So for all those parts they accepted. But what they had to accept, the pramana of the Atma, the Upanishad, they left out unfortunately. Yeah. So, it was a great thing. Yeah. And because they accepted the energy work, etc., those type of things they developed very well. So, that aspect grew very well. The energy work, the physical health, the energy, your martial arts, healing things. Yeah. So, all those things developed well.
But it was all Bhagavani, Adhara, Vedika,
How do you?
The whole thing collapses because it is all without any basis.
Exactly, because moksha is not there. Everything else is there.
No, yeah. How can you have
exactly.
How can you have everything?
So because finally it's supposed to be shunya. Yeah, that's why in my discussion with the modern Buddhists, when you discuss with them, they accept some of these things. So that's how you coined the term, non-conceptual reality. A reality that cannot be conceived of, which they are comfortable with. What you call shunya is actually a non-conceptual reality. That word we can accept. It's the same as nirgunam brahman. Okay. I'm putting nirgunam brahman into English. Brahman, the reality, truth. Nirguna, without any qualities, etc. Therefore, you can't conceive of it. It's not supposed to be conceived of. It's supposed to be recognized. But non-conceptual. Okay. A middle ground, a meeting ground is established. Okay, yeah. Okay. Therefore, all the this. Then, clear up to know as this. So, the main argument is with respect to your experience. If shunya, the world itself will not be there, you will not be there, there is no experience of it. Okay. This is the main three arguments that is presented. Okay. Then, he had said continuity is an illusion. Okay? Atma ikshanikam, but the continuity is an illusion. That is being answered now. Pratyabhijna yadi bhrantihi bhojanadi katam bhaje bhaved ishta sadhanam etad. Annam gatadi navat iti nishchitya balaopi bhojanado pravartate pratyabhijna yadi bhranti syat. Here pratyabhijna. Pratyabhijna is what? Two things. This is the same book I used last week. Last class also I used the same book. That recognition that this is the same thing I have seen before. That's called pratyabhijna with respect to the object. Similarly, this pratyabhijna with respect to I. The I who's awake now was the same I that was dreaming. Was the same I that went into deep sleep. And now awake. Hopefully, sitting in the class. Hopefully, kabhi add karna padta hai. So, this is the same guy. That is called pratyabhijna. With respect to object, with respect to myself. Okay. He says that pratyabhijna is bhranti, a delusion. How are you going and eating a meal? Why? Why? Because look at it. Ishta sadhanam evetad annam. Gata dina annavat. Gata dina annavat. This food that is there in the kitchen is desirable. Why? Like the food I ate yesterday. Like the food I ate yesterday. Gata dina annavat. Iti nishchitya, having ascertained this, bala api bhojanado pravartate. Even a child goes to eat because of that only. No? If you don't recognize that that food satisfied your hunger, how are you going to go and eat today? Every day has been a new experience. So do you think this food will satisfy you? I don't know. I have not eaten it. Does anybody say that? Unless you are coming across some new exotic meal which you have not tasted before. Which in Bombay is difficult. We have tasted Indian-ified version of everything. Therefore, means what? Two things are coming here. Pratyabhijna, I was the hungry one. And I became the satisfied person. Now I am the hungry person again. You are experiencing a continuity there. You are experiencing a continuity with food also. This was the has food that satisfied my hunger yesterday. This will be the food that will satisfy the hunger today. So with respect to I, the Pratyabhijna is there. With respect to the food, the Pratyabhijna is there. Correct? Then, you will have to say, both are illusions. The Buddha says, both are illusions. Now, understand one thing very clearly. For the snake to appear, what has to be there? Rope. If you are saying, we are walking on the road. Okay? Hey, as a snake, be careful. Snake. And you are telling me, the snake is mithya, not true. I say, oh, what is there is rope? No. Now what is there? Nothing. Then how am I seeing snake? Illusion. Where is my stick gone? I better be careful. Why? Because something, for an appearance to be there, something has to be there to appear, no? Because there is a rope there, you can mistake it for a snake or something else. But a mistaken perception implies that there has to be something there. I experience a finitude. I experience sorrow. If somebody comes and tells me that's because of ajnanam, ignorance, it's delusory, etc. I'll say, okay, then what am I really? You don't exist. That means something that is non-existent has manifested as an existent being going through an experience on top of it. How can nothingness manifest? How can nothingness manifest into two things? Into an entity and with an object of experience. Like your dream. In the dream I was there, na? My mind was there, na? To manifest as the dreamer and the experience both. It's me alone. So I was there. You can't say, you dreamt but you were not there. In any experience, you are the important entity. No? Because of you, there is an experience that is happening. So, if that person is dismissed, see, in Vedanta also, we dismiss the experiencer. But we dismiss the experiencer by saying the experiencer is a manifestation of I awareness. If I am Shunya, it cannot manifest into an experience or anything else. Because I am not there. What is on top of the table here, other than the recorder, in this area? Nothingness, no? On top of the table, there is nothing. Empty space is there. Will you see suddenly a nice bouquet manifesting here? Why? Because there is nothing to manifest. Can you, however creative you are, delude into yourself into thinking that there is a beautiful bouquet, a vase with a nice bouquet of flowers kept inside? Try. Imagine and try it. You can imagine. But you can't see.
Imagination, I must
be there. Yeah. So to even let us say there is one character who is very good at delusory thinking. And he deluded himself to thinking there. Could that thinking have happened unless he was there? And that delusory thing will not be available for a transaction. Here the world is available for a transaction. Therefore, kinchit bhavam you have to give it. You can't say the base is shunya. If you say base is shunya, there is nothing. That'll be like the emperor's clothes. From nothing you made the clothes. From nothingness, nothing will come. There has to be something. Because we are experiencing the world as an existing entity. I experience myself as existence. Even if I go into samadhi, the same thing will be there. The one who was awake and disturbed is the one who went into samadhi. All peaceful, great, blissful it was. And then, now the guy coming out, waiting to see when he can go back again. I will never experience myself as aham shunya, I am not there. Deep sleep, do you say I am not there? Pratyek vijna is there. I was the one who went to sleep, now I am awake. Kaisa tha nind, maja aaya. Aray, there was a mild earthquake here. Really, I didn't know. The world, I didn't know. But I knew I am there, not experiencing anything other than me. Whether the blanket covered me or not, ignorance covered me. I know that also. Not only I knew that I am, I also knew I was ignorant of everything else. Blanket, I threw it off or not, I don't remember. I don't know. Sometimes you may get up to find the blanket on the floor if you are a very restless sleeper. That I don't know. But I slept well. I know that. Therefore, the pratyabhijna continues. Okay, you are saying it's the Buddha is saying it's a delusion. I'm willing to accept it. Okay? That's an appearance. So what was there to appear as the pratyabhijna? Because remember, appearance means something has to be there to appear. The cloth can appear as a kurta. No problems. And if there's not enough cloth, kurti. Short. And if the tailor cannot cut straight, you'll get the modern cuts, okay? You'll get all that. So, but something has to be there, no? We are not talking about a non-existent reality behind the world. We have to talk about the existent reality behind the world. That's why the moment they started taking shunya as a reality, after that there was no other Buddha. Buddha was there, fine. Buddha, wise person, why? No hassles. Why am I saying this? Because I met so many Buddhist masters, great souls, very committed, serious persons. I mean, their discipline, you know, I respect. Great regard for them. And I always greet them. My standard with me now. And to the Buddha, my salutations. Always greet them respectfully. And they'll always say, I am not Buddha. I am only a Bodhisattva. Even the Dalai Lama says that. Bodhisattva. Why? I have not yet experienced I am Shunya. How can you? When you are there. How can you experience yourself as not being there? So then the theory of an evolving Buddha came up. Look at it. Once you have one mistake, either you can correct that mistake and say, forget it, this is not correct. Buddha was a wise person. Buddha didn't teach. Therefore, we are now imposing what the teaching is about. We are speculating on that. Or you have to explain that. Why? It takes many lifetimes. Where did they get that? It takes many lifetimes. Something that is not there is going through many lifetimes, okay? Gadbada hai. Something which is not there is taking birth again. No, that's because all the skandhas are kept together by karma. Okay. Skandhas are kept together by karma. But there is no karta. No, there is an illusion of a karta. And therefore the illusion of skandhas kept together, okay? All right. I accepted. So, this karma. So, you are evolving now. This lifetime, I cannot experience. I am shunya. Why? Because I am there. Last lifetime, same thing happened. Previous lifetime, same thing happened. So, this lifetime, ab to bilkul buda hoon. Goli khakar jita hoon. In spite of my energy work, etc. Buddha to ho jayega. Correct? All my energy work keeps me good. At 80, I'll still wield a sword. That many youngsters will say, wow, this guy is something. All right, fine. But aging will happen. And one day you'll be gone. Correct? Every wise person is gone someday or the other. Every ignorant person also is gone someday or the other. Okay. So now, I don't think this lifetime I can experience I am shunyaha. 50 years I have been meditating. It is a big struggle because I started when I was 5 years old. I came to the monastery and ever since there I have been engaged in it. At least Buddha had 30 years of normal life before. He experienced the pleasures of life. So for me to get over the need for pleasure, etc. was a struggle. This is how the Buddhists will talk. And correct also. If you experience some life and then go, it's better. All right. So this lifetime, I am shunya. I don't think I can get it. But I lived my life well with all that. The samskaras are good. Samskaras become part of what? Vedanaskanda. Yeah, Vedanaskanda. According to Buddhism, we are talking. All right. So this type of time, I am a bodhisattva, all right, because I am on the way. I'll be born again and pick up the thread again. Great. Because you'll be born next time. According to what Vedanta look, yoga brashta. Therefore, great soul, he'll pick it up fast. All right. So again, as a youngster, this lifetime as a youngster, why? Because there are some regrets he had not experienced life last time. So he experienced life a bit, etc. In the first 20 years, he was a bit of a freaked out a bit. But after that, fine. Yeah. What are the chances of him experiencing aham shunya? I am there. How can you experience I am not there? So in no lifetime are you going to experience aham shunya. Even though they have actually experienced samadhi, all that they have. But they will look upon themselves as not yet. They will postpone their realization. I find that tragic. From the Buddhist masters I have spoken to, that aspect I find it tragic. They'll also tell me that last bit, I'm not getting it. Correct? How will you get it? I'm shunya, how will you get it? So I tell them, look at it like that. It's a reality which is non-conceptual. They think, he says, yeah, that makes sense because I am there. So it's a reality which you cannot conceive of. That makes sense. Shunya, translate. Don't translate shunya as nothingness. Translate shunya as non-conceptual reality. Then it's easier for them. Yeah. In fact, even when you read a report, this is how you take it. It's better that way. Because then what they are saying will have some sense in the whole thing. Of course, pure shunya cannot exist. Nature abhors a vacuum. It won't be there. Nothingness cannot be there. So the great void, etc., will not be there. But in your Sahasranama also, there is there shunya, shunyave namaha, etc. What about that? Correct, it is there. And we also say something else in the same Sahasranama. If a word Shunyave Namaha is used, within the next few, you will find Shunya Sakshine Namaha. The one who has seen that Shunya, meaning the nothingness that is there in the mind, you have objectified it. There was Shunya Sakshine Namaha. That also you will find. Check up the Sahasranama. Some dozen of them I have read at some time or the other in my life. It was all there. That means what? We are not using the term Shunya for the Atma. Unless you are using it to describe it as free from something else. But that's in your mind. Idea. Shunya is an idea. It's Indians who gave the world both the idea of Shunya, nothingness, zero, and the idea of infinity. Purnam. Correct? Therefore, pure nothingness is only an idea, concept. Pure Shunya is only a concept. Why? The one who holds that concept in the mind, that guy, I am there. Not only I am there, my mind also has to be there to have an idea of Shunya. Because the concept, no? The mind has to be there. Then what is the non-conceptual reality? Nirgunam Brahman. Brahman alone. Satyam Jnanam Anantam. Satyam Jnanam Anantam is not a concept anyway. We have seen that elaborately. Satyam Jnanam Anantam is not a concept. It's the reality of what you are. It's not a guna. It's three words referring to the truth of what you are. Where the word meaning is dropped and the implied meaning of what I am is taken up. The direct word meaning is dropped. All that we see in elaborately. Therefore, that Shunya is something that, yeah. The closest experience you can get is Samadhi experience. Which is great, good, but it's an experience. Samadhi is only an experience. It's like, I have all experience outside, now let me see what experience I'm having inside. And then saying, forget all experiences, I want to be free from all experiences. Okay, you're free from all experiences in deep sleep anyway. But if you want to have a conscious experience like that, fine, Samadhi may jao. It's very good for mastering the mind, okay? The Samadhi practice is very good for mastering the mind. Your mind will get mastered very well. Why? Because you can think when you want, you cannot think when you want. Hey, that's great. So I'm thinking on this line. Lateral thinking, think differently. How do you shift from there to here? Come back, nothing, and then go back again. But this coming back, going back, split second. The mind is the fastest thing in the world. So you can change your patterns of thinking, you can change your patterns of behavior. All that will become much easier with the Samadhi practice. I'm not denying that at all. It's good for sure. Yeah? Yeah. That all they take it. Yeah, all that is very clear. Skandhas, no? Doesn't really, not me. Other than me, it's an instrument anyway. All that they take very clearly. So the Samadhi experience gives them great people. There's no doubt about that. Total mastery of the mind, etc. You know, can learn to ignore heat and cold, all that, the challenges of life, no problem. Can be peaceful. Because when they face a challenge, only they say, to kya farak pada? It helps, no? Whereas because we take the reality as a basis, for us there is a functional reality. So for us to deal with it, we have to have the prasada buddhi, etc. Can you see how the cultures differed? When a student of Vedanta is facing the world and there is a challenging situation, difficult situation, Ishvara comes into the picture, prasada buddhi, etc. Fine. When the Bauddha student goes into that, he has to refer back to this. It's all just an illusion. You're suffering. That's also just a Vedana Skanda illusion. Not real. It helps. They will deal with the world as well as we can deal with the world. In that, there is no difference. probably better. Why? Because a series about it, we are not. The Buddhist practitioner is much more serious than the other practitioners, other religious practitioners. They are much more serious. Especially the Zen Buddhism. I never seen people so committed and so serious in their practice. By the end of the day, this is the thing. Aham Shunya cannot be an object of experience. Or the subject of experience. Because I'm not Shunya, I'm there. So whatever you do. And those rules and regulations becomes important. Why? Because you need to have a mastered mind before you can go in Samadhi. When your mind is being pulled in 10 different directions, where can you go into Samadhi? I went to a house Christmas Eve. I have a friend who is a non-practicing Catholic. Okay, he's a non-practicing Christian. He comes for all the Vedanta lectures and everything. He knew my teacher also very well. He's a wonderful social activist also. So this guy, but he always throws a Christmas Eve party. So I went for that. So big discussion in one of the rooms. There were a lot of people in one of the rooms. Big discussion going on. Yeah, meditation. How? Mera man chup nahi hota hai. And the person saying, kyun chup karne ka? Jaane dena usko. Before they could turn to me and ask, I quietly slipped away. Christmas party. Everyone is getting spiritual. What am I going to talk with? That talk, let it remain there. And they looked around, Swamiji kidhar gaya? Swamiji gul ho gaya udhar. Aur kidhar gaya? Why? That's not the time to talk about this thing. Because it is true, when the mind is scattered so much, how are you going to sit in Samadhi? So you are taught to have a discipline that mind. So they use various exercises, various rules, regulations to discipline that mind. Including the practice of martial arts, etc. Because that's one of the, what do you call, strictest disciplines you can find. Yeah. Put up with discomfort, this, that. Yeah. Martial arts, you have to put up with a lot of discomfort. Why? René Descartes, the French philosopher, said, I think, therefore I am. What does a martial artist say? I ache, therefore I am. Another guy talking. He's also, all the time, there is some ache or pain in him. Practice me both margada. No, he's very good. Nobody can touch him. Yeah, but he has to get to go through some conditioning. So stand here. Okay, 10 punches. Pat, pat, pat. He goes, another guy, 10 punches. Discipline. If you can put up with that type of discomfort, what about worldly discomfort? Arre, we are local, mein goth crowd hai. Kuch farak nahi padta. Of course there is crowd. You're crushed from all sides. Who's crushed? I'm standing. Others are coming, hitting against me and going away. Mere ko kya farak pada? You stand rooted like a rock. And you're kind, you'll give place for others. Aja, aja. So, discipline is good. Because then the mind is not scattered. Yeah. You develop a contemplative mind. If you develop a contemplative mind, then to go into Samadhi is easy. And if you go into Samadhi, the mind is even much more disciplined. Very good. Excellent. But even that mind is not going to experience Aham Shunya. I am not there. You can't experience because Me Una. The Atma is always there. I am there. Mind is gone. Everything is gone. Desire is gone, this gone, that gone, disturbance gone, everything gone. What is there? I. Great. Then in that mind you should put what? What exactly is there? Yours. Mahavakya Upadesha should happen there. Tattva Masi Iti. When that happens, everything is fine. That's why yoga became, in the Indian context, that yoga, the practice of Samadhi, became preparation for Vedanta. Are you getting that? It became great preparation. So I have a friend who is very much into all this. He also tells me, you know that last bit I can't get. I'm still trying. I said, practice another 5 years, then come back to me. Practice another 5 years, then I'll tell you why it won't work. But thoda, you have to experience it, because they are very experience oriented. So if you experience it, it doesn't work. Only then you can be taught what works. Don't work. It's easy. For someone like that guy, it'll be easy. For a Zen monk, it's very easy to know the truth. But through that meditative practice, you're not going to come to know Aham Shunya. No meditation will give you Aham Shunya. Even Shunya meditation. There's a Shunya meditation going around. Very popular. Including Jaggi Vasudev and all does that. Very good thing. It's complete emptying the mind. The shunyata of the mind. Good. But not I. Not I. I am there very much. Whatever you negate, at the end of all negation, abhaditam satyam. You know the reality, that which cannot be negated because you are there. Therefore, abhaditam satyam becomes the basis, not shunya. Okay. Then, we had said, what is the purpose, etc., hano, padanam, etc.? It's a very different topic altogether. That starts with the next verse. So that we will see next class. I'm stopping 10 minutes earlier because this will be a huge topic by itself. If I started, I'll need half an hour straight. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So Om Tat Sat. Good place to stop.
Swamiji, yeah? It seems like that the first follower of Buddha made a mistake, you know, of, because no sane person would say that this is out of the thing.
Not first follower. 500 years after him.
No, but that mistake, you know, by calling it Shunya.
Yeah, so continued.
Then they are still struggling to explain that as a common meaning of nothingness.
So it was not the first follower. It came 500 years after Buddha. Yeah. Nagarjuna said it. Yeah. Nagarjuna was the person who used that term.